Today's speaker, Dr. Satheesh Reddy, had just arrived. I request today's speaker, Dr. Satheesh Reddy, to come on the stage. I also request the chairman of the session, Honorable Jayant Patil. Honorable Jayant Patil, sir, please come on the stage, please. Good evening, all of you. On behalf of organizers, I welcome you all for the public speech session on the first day of 5th Bharatiya Vidyan Sammelan 2017. The topic of today's speech is related to technological advancements in Indian defense. In the fast-changing technological world, where the development is happening every day and every minute, we as common people always wonder whether these changes are reflected in our defense systems or not. Today's speaker, Dr. Satheesh Reddy, will try to answer such questions in our mind. All of us know that Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was commonly referred as missile man of India. Now we can say the new missile man is coming on the horizon. I now briefly introduce him. Dr. Satheesh Reddy did his BTech from Jawaharlal Nehru Technological University at Anantapur and did MS and PhD from Jawaharlal Nehru Technical University, Hyderabad. Currently, he is the scientific advisor to Raksha Mantri. Dr. Reddy is basically an aerospace scientist. He is also the Director General of Missiles and Strategic Systems. He has pioneered many technological developments for Indian missile and made the great contribution towards the successful flight testing of ICBM Agni 5 mission. He led the RCI lab as program director for successful development of medium range surface to air missile. He is the fellow of many societies and academies in the scientific world. He is the recipient of about 10 prestigious awards for his contribution in critical avionic systems and diversified navigation technologies. He has, to his credit, honorary Doctor of Science from several universities in India. We are very fortunate to have equally and highly accomplished person to chair today's session, Honorable Mr. Jayant Patil. I will now introduce him briefly. Honorable Jayant Patil is the Senior Vice President of Aerospace and Heavy Engineering Division in Larsen & Toubro. Also, he is the Director of L&T Sister Concerns. He did M.Tech in Mechanical Engineering from IIT Powai. He led a team that designed and developed the complex weapon systems for DRDO, Indian Navy, Army, and Air Force. Due to his efforts and vision, the L&T is at unique positions in the defense sector of India. Currently, he oversees the defense and aerospace strategic business in the R&D centers of L&T throughout India. Honorable Mr. Patil has been groomed to top management position through many business schools, including Harvard Business School. He is a member of National Committee on Defense of Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industries and Confederation of Indian Industries. With these introductions, may I now request Dr. Satheesh Reddy to start his speech. Dr. Reddy.
Shri Jayant Patil ji, the Vice President Larsen and Turbo, the one industry which works with us very closely last almost over 30-35 years, more like part and parcel of Government of India. Very nice to have him as a chair of this session today here. Sri Jayant Sasrabudeji, all other important functionaries of Vignan Bharati, other eminent people from various walks of science and technology who are present here, very good evening to all of you. In fact, it's a proud privilege for me to be here in this campus of Ferguson College, a very, very popular college, a famous college in India and abroad. I was here in Pune for about a year, in the year 1985. That time I have learnt a lot about Pune and then about this college. A very old college. I don't have to tell you about it, but what I have learnt, I have to tell you, I thought so. Not that you do not know. Started way back 1885, none other than the famous leader of the country, Bal Gangadhar Tilak ji, who was part of the governing council, started the educational society here, Deccan Educational Society. Famous people whom we actually remember every day, who have studied here, Veera Savarkar ji. Then of course the famous, our prime ministers, Sri P.V. Narasimha Rao, Sri V.P. Singh, many foreign nationals who have studied here. In fact, it is, even today I was finding out today, there are more than about 800 students who are studying here, out of roughly about 3,000 to 3,500 students here, roughly counting it to be about 1/4 of the students as foreign national students, which actually helps a lot. In fact, I have understood a couple of my far relatives have gone to Africa to do agriculture there. Lots of acres, about 5,000 acres, 10,000 acres and things like that. That's out of the connection because those people who are the kings or the rulers from that country, they have studied here in Pune and most of them in Ferguson College. And that is how the contact established, and that's how they have the respect for Indians, and so they have encouraged these people. There are many people who do agriculture there in African countries, and the credit goes to Ferguson College. I'm very happy to be here in this college here today. Not that because I'm here in Pune and I have to address you here, I've been always saying that for me, the most liked place in the country is Pune. Somehow, the most enjoyed period for me also after my education from the college was my stay here 1 year in Pune, where I enjoyed every day. In fact, I think when I stayed here for about 340 days, almost 300 days I came to Deccan Gymkhana. Every day almost. I was in Kadakwasla, every day evening I used to come here and then go to Pune Vidyapeeth and then go back and all that. And Pune is a very important place, very important city for the defense of the country. Lot of defense establishments are there here. And all of you know that most importantly, the largest hospital, a military hospital is here. Many military establishments are there. Then, importantly, the DRDO establishments also large in number here in this city. Whether it is ARDE, Pune, Pashan, whatever we have, or HMRL, or R&D engineers. Then we also have institutes here around Kharagpur. The DIAT or the MILIT, two institutes which are there, which are part of the DRDO and then CIDS. Then we also have established a couple of new establishments on the outskirts of the city, very important ones. So they all contribute a lot to this country's defense, and many, many products which have come out of these laboratories here in Pune have contributed to the development of indigenous technologies in this country. Many of you must have seen the products what DRDO has developed, and most of them are from Pune laboratories. At least 50% of them are from the laboratories here in Pune, which have been exhibited here. In fact, I was very happy to see, even though it is Bharatiya Vaigyanik Sammelan, where all scientific organizations are supposed to be contributing and displaying all their technologies, products, and related science and technologies, I think the DRDO products are almost about 70 to 75%, which are present there. I'm very happy for that, and I congratulate the DRDO team for such a vast presence here. And also, I've been hearing that the response from the public also has been huge. They've been visiting the places. In fact, I also had last half an hour, I was visiting their large crowd. Even now at about evening 7:30, people are there seeing. A lot of interest is generated in that. We'll be very happy if this interest, what is generated today, if it cultivates that we need to work for the country's indigenous technologies here. We also contribute a lot for the defense and make the country very self-reliant by this exhibition. That is, of course, the motto why Vignan Bharati has started these Vaigyanik Sammelans, wherein the science and technology to be promoted, and we should become a world leader in the science and technology. Coming to the defense technologies, if you look back ancient history, way back in Vedic history, or even the period of Rigveda, that is the first time a Rath has come. That is the first time people started using Rath. And then a king is known for how many Raths he has got, whether it is single horse Rath or multiple horse Rath. And that is the one which has been used in the wars first time. And in fact, probably I think the names have come as Dasharath, Shatarath, Sahasrarath. He is out of how many Raths he was holding also. If Dasharath is 10 and then Shatarath is 100 and 1000 Raths he has got, Sahasrarath and things like that have been the names which have been given to them. And that's how the war actually originally started, with using vehicles, armaments, and things like that and all that. From there, it went on to building the ships, both for transportation and other purposes. India was one of the country which has produced ships which had the capacity even those days to accommodate more than 800 people, probably about close to 30 to 300 tons of load even those days. Even if you look at the history, the West Bengal king, what he has sent his prince also was carrying about 800 passengers on board with facilities to rooms and things like that for the people. So that is the next development what took place from Rath. Likewise, many developments. India was very, very strong in metallurgy. Unfortunately, we are not today, but India was very strong in metallurgy. the steel what has been produced in India was very popularly sold elsewhere in the world. Entire world, actually, we have been supplying the steel which actually came from southern part of this country. Otherwise also, various pockets in the country developed various metallurgy-related technologies. Meerut is one of that. Then Rajasthan is one of that. Maybe about 200 kilometers from here is one. Adilabad is another one center. A lot of centers have developed various technologies in the metallurgy-related aspects, which is very important for any country's development. But then, after that, out of the metallurgy, a lot of swords have come, and then horse-related technology, and even elephants being used in the warfare. That has been a very popular technology. In fact, I think I'm right. When Purus has come here, the Alexander has come, and King Purushottam was fighting with him. That is the first time they have seen elephants actually coming in the warfare and how we can utilize the elephants in a warfare. And the people were scared. They were actually calling that, first day when they saw the elephants in the warfare coming, they called them as moving mountains. They never saw that elephants are there and there is a size and they can participate in the war. And Alexander was afraid of these elephants and calling them moving mountains are coming towards us. So this is how we have utilized in various elements and various animals also in the warfare. And being top of the defense technologies in the nation, in the world, later out of the domination, out of the slavery what we had, out of the many kings who have dominated us came from outside, the technologies and various science and technology institutions what we had in the country have died down. And we came to rock bottom, both in thinking-wise, thinking that we don't have the knowledge and we cannot develop the things and we don't have the technology. And we started as if we are at rock bottom at the zero level. After independence, again the institutions started coming up. 1950s and 1960s, various institutions have been started in the country. DRDO is also one of that institutions which have been started. In fact, originally it was called as Defense Science Organization, DSO, and later it became Defense Research and Development Organization later, and started working on technologies. In fact, when I say that, I have to talk about three departments which are strategically very important for the country. The three departments are the Department of Space, the Department of Atomic Energy, and then the Department of Defense R&D. These three are very important and they are called the strategic departments of the country. I don't want to enter into the other departments. The time also won't be sufficient for that. But if you look at these three departments, even though the work, as I said, about 1960s the work started, and 1970s you started showing your presence. The first experiment started. Till the time, we were almost not having anything. No infrastructure, no scientific talent in the country which is working in this direction, no establishments, and no industry base also. In fact, I was wondering just now, Mr. Jayant Patil was telling that with the DRDO, they started working from 1987 onwards. That is the period. See, it is about 30 years back. Before that, we didn't have anything. So I'll come to that topic also a little later. So when you look at it, 1960s and 1970s, when we started the experiment, the SLV-3, which Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam started, was the project director. First flight was a failure. And that is where I think they started learning. And the successes, the taste of success started later and then went on. Today, if you look at it, what we thought from SLV, it went to ASLV, and then PSLV, Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, which actually delivers payloads in the polar orbit, anything from 400 kilometers or 350 kilometers.